Hello, my soul tribes. Welcome to my channel. I'm Celeste TT Tarot, and we're going to do my Cup of Loves, my Pisces reading. I'm going to play some music. I'm playing Love My 90s R&B because it's springtime. Love is in the air. I'm in the Chicago region, so the weather is not so great here, but that's okay. Still feeling that Pisces mood. So Bring It All to Me featuring NSYNC is playing by Black, which is BLAQUE. It's an old school group. It's like a girl group. So my Pisces, I hope y'all are doing good, enjoying your season. It is at the end, so because we're pretty mysterious, I have Pisces in my chart. Let's get started. Of course, I'm going to start off with the moon for you guys. We've got to get some higher perspectives here for my Pisces is what's going on in the moon. So, this is for my Pisces. So we are not King and Queen of Cups energy. Okay. See how we're doing in the soul space. Your dreams need a practical plan. Full moon in Taurus. So a lot of you guys may be dreaming. In this like dreamy mode here. Trying to see if I can make the color better. The universe wants you to have a practical plan, so they want you to ground yourself. So, when it comes to earth energy, put some light on. When it comes to earth energy, see if you can see it. It's probably best to have like a more grounded perspective, ground your soul. And Taurus energy is very solid, so a lot of you guys might need to take your time. Clear out your soul space and start making plans. So if you're in this like dreamy energy when it comes to like what's for your highest good and having a higher perspective, you need to start making plans towards that and not just dreaming about it. Okay, Pisces, step out of your comfort zone for your mind. North Node. So if you are a Pisces sun, well, typically your North Node would be, you should look up your birth chart, but typically your North Node would be the opposite. So some of you guys need to go back and forth between, the opposite sign of Pisces is Leo. So some of you guys need to go back and forth between, you know, being in your emotional space as well as being in your action-oriented space. And that's why they talked about the planning. So you need to bring those together. And right now it's 2023, Chariot energy. So fire and water makes the Chariot. So that would definitely be Cancer. Some of you guys be dealing with, want to have that in your chart. It's time to step out of your comfort zone. In your mind, your mental space. Time to take action on plans. And then in the 3D space, it's a time for healing. Basaltic moon. So some of you guys need to do some emotional cleansing. And heal your emotional space in the 3D. Love Like This just came on, and it's by Faith Evans. So working on your faith, healing, having faith. So work back on restoring your faith. It's a time for healing. And then overall, we have a new romantic cycle begins, new moon in Libra. So that's air energy. So, I was right about the romance going around. Some of you guys are starting new relationships, getting into relationships, restoring old relationships, divine counterparts, whatever you resonate with. So, I'm seeing here fire, earth, and air energy. Well, all the four elements. So, a lot of you guys need to work on alchemizing. So, your soul space, you need to ground your soul. Take action in your mind. To heal, and when you think about healing, to emotionally cleanse, And you have to, in order to be more wiser, and balance yourself out for a new relationship. So a lot of you guys are ending old cycles and entering into new cycles. Happy for you. So let's look at the elements here and get some more clarity on that. That you were mine. Yeah, yeah. Clarity for my Pisces. Maybe if you last forever. Let's see what we got. Baby, trying to understand, I'd be crazy if you knew what you've done to me. Okay, yeah. Okay. In your soul space, we got card number 41, time. So, discipline. So, as I said, earth energy, time, discipline, it kind of talks about, it could be divine time in card number 41. So, four is Aries season, emperor energy, and tarot. One is like magician manifesting. So, to manifest your dreams, you need a practical plan. Five is also Taurus energy. So you could be dealing one and have that in your chart, because 4 + 1 = 5, the Hierophant, divine timing. Let's see. They do have this card in here. I have a book. I'll read it. But the element is definitely earth. No, the element here is air. Sorry. But it has a tree in here. So I'm thinking earth and air energy. So really, because it's like clocks in here and then there's a tree. So divine timing. It's like if you want something to come to fruition, you definitely need a practical plan. So you need to combine earth and air energy in your soul space. But be patient with yourself, because air energy can kind of be quick. So that's why you need to work on grounding yourself. Like earth energy is grounding. So find out the causes of your procrastination or resistance. Do not miss your opportunities. Someone is wasting your time. Be aware of this. You have finite time on this planet, so use it well. Okay, so that's air. The next one we have for your mental space is Purity Ice 33. So purifying your mind. Ice is like ice and fire. It's kind of like those two elements as I was mentioning. Card number 33. So 3 is Empress energy. 3 is Empress energy put together. 6, Lover's energy. Could be dealing with Gemini. Have that in your chart. What else? So you got like 2 Empresses. Purifying your mind. Stepping out of your comfort zone. Taking action. So some of you guys could be trying to make decisions here. So let me give you more clarity on that. Maybe going in a different direction. The way forward is clear. See nature in its purity. Let it comfort you and strip away what is unnecessary. Freeze out what is not a benefit to you at this time. When you look at things clearly, there will be purity to solution. So that's water. Yeah. So fire and water. Chariot. Because if you see here, there's a horse in the picture. While she's kind of stuck trying to make a decision. So it's like 2 decisions you can make. Possibly 2 pathways. Because it's seeing here that if you're elevated and you see yourself as an empress, then there's 2 pathways you can take. You can either stay stuck or you can move forward. And the cherry energy that I was saying to take action. So that's that fire and water energy I was talking about in your mind. So just keep moving forward. And what's not a benefit for you, just freeze that out. Like, if it's not helping you, if it's keeping you stuck, then just keep moving forward in your mind. And then the time for healing, we have Completion West, card number 4. So I was talking about that alchemy energy. So card number 4, we're in Aries season, shortly hitting that. So that talks about the emperor energy, taking control of your life, being a boss, moving forward. That's earth energy here. Every cycle comes to a close. Do not resist the end of something because the end heralds a new beginning. Complete the project. Be a finisher. Be not afraid of death. It is a part of life. So some of you guys are going through a transformation. You need to ground that by healing. So that's earth energy. So earth and water, doing emotional cleansing to alchemize. Complete out things that need to be wiped out so you can start something new. And then when it comes to that new romantic cycle, we have snow, silence as the overall card, number 34, that chariot energy again. So the divine's telling you guys to like really move forward, do the cleansing you need to do. And I'll read that one for you. Allow yourself to soften. Don't speak just for the sake of it. You do not need to issue an opinion on everything. Choose your words carefully. Sometimes observing is the best way to gain information and trust. So a lot of you guys can just move in silence, be quiet right now. Water energy. So you guys are very well aware of that because the moon energy is really quiet. So taking a moment of silence to allow the cycle to begin. So just sit back and observe, allow. I'll see in card number 3 and 4. So some of you guys could be entering into another relationship, partnership ordained by the Most High, the Divine, God, whoever you resonate with. But you have two pathways possibly in your mind that's keeping you stuck. One's keeping you stuck, one allows you to move forward. So the Divine just wants you to focus on you and keep moving forward. What is in the benefit for you? It's not. Some of you guys who are King of Cups, Divine Masculines, you need to do some healing and really contemplate about what divine timing is or what it means for you. Some of you guys are stepping into a new cycle to have to ground your energy in an earthly way, but learning how to alchemize that with air, making like being wiser as the experiences you went through, and also grounding yourself when it comes to like your emotions. Maturing, so freezing out what's no longer of benefit to you. Some of you guys are going in another direction than what you're used to, and that's the way that you heal, so you can start something new. You have to close out one thing and then begin something new. So we have Come and Talk to Me by Jodeci. So yeah, some of you guys are definitely stepping into a new romantic cycle. I'm happy. That's great. So, happy to hear that. So we're going to do Starseed Oracle. I'm going to do you guys 3. Let's see. Oh, this is my song. I Want to Be Down by Brandy. Okay, I'm hearing y'all. So I was right to pick this little playlist.
I would like to get to know if I could be the kind of girl that you could be down for. 'Cause when I look at you, I feel something tell me you're the kind of guy that I should make a move on.
Okay, soul space, you're not alone. Isolation, physical connection, and community. So some of you guys been like kind of isolating yourself, possibly in the form of hermit mode. I know I have. Then if you're like in this dream phase and considering timing, planning, the Divine wants you to know you're not alone. You're still a part of the community, but this is the perfect time to isolate, ground yourself, and take your time to be practical about what it is that you actually want and how you can move forward. So let's get, I can open that up too. Lonely, look at that.
Reason they have someone to care for. Baby, all you need's a shoulder to cry on.
See, the older the soul, the deeper the cave. Many starseeds and old souls enjoy their own company. Spending time alone can be comforting and necessary for their vitality, as it allows them to commune with their soul and fill up their energetic resources, especially if they have an underactive or open root chakra or find it hard being human. Many starseeds find it more nourishing to retreat than to spend their time in meaningless conversations and relationships. However, we must remember that we're not here to go about this life alone. Humans are pack animals, and we all need the love, company, and support of others, both emotionally and physically. In our increasingly online world, we can be connected to more people and yet feel more alone and isolated than ever. There's still so much we don't know about the energetic side effects of things like social media. What is it doing to our auric field? So the main message is to step out of your cave and physically reach out to those in your life to replenish what you need, but to not isolate yourself. Seeing friends and family who live nearby, regular catch up and walk with someone. In what ways can you open yourself up to the people who are physically in your life, those you truly know? So it's time for you guys to get out. It's the springtime, the weather's getting better. Where I'm at is cold, so there'll be times when I'll be going out and other times I'll just stay in. So it's like, ground yourself, start planning, being practical about it, taking your time to kind of get to know the facets of what it is you want in your life. And you're not alone, so if you need to isolate yourself to replenish, that's okay. In fact, you should be doing that, but don't isolate yourself to the point where you're not like connected in with people who've always been there for you, who support you, who love you, and who also help fill up your cup, because you still need to stay connected, especially Pisces, with those cups of love. So if you guys have been isolating, some of you guys are refilling. You're just refueling right now, revamping for a new romantic cycle. And then your mental space, star ancestors, hidden secrets, lost wisdom. Look a little deeper. So you need to look deeper into something. And let's see what you need to look into, because your ancestors are trying to show you something. You're here to remember and uncover ancient secrets and transmissions, technology and wisdom that are so needed on the planet right now. To unlock your soul's memories of a time when we lived in harmony on Earth and one day will again. So step into your ancient knowingness. To be held by the rememberings of the star ancestors. To look a little deeper. If you're feeling stuck, you're being called to do something different. Change your point of view. Creativity happens when we put together two things that don't belong. When we do the unexpected. So often a creative solution is right in front of us, but because we think the same thoughts and act the same way, we miss what's in the open. So it's like mystic knowing blooms in your heart. So the way... So it's like listen to your heart and soul. So if your heart is telling you practically... And your soul is telling you practically, practicality and timing. Could be time for some of you guys to reconnect in a way where you set healthy boundaries. And you need to do it out of a heart space and not out of like practicality and emotions. When you merge those together, like earth and water energy, you can like build something solid. So you need to think, what is it, what it is that you want, what it is that you see out of life, and like plan that. Like even if it's something you are dreaming of, like what would be the steps, at least look them up to do that, and then start taking action towards that, because your ancestors don't want you frozen. They see you in these like going back and forth between like what path to take. And it's like, well, just step out of your comfort zone and try something different every now and then. Because they're always, your ancestors are always going to chart a path for you no matter what. So there's nothing to be afraid of. You don't need to just stay isolated if you don't want to. And when you feel like you need to refill, then do that. Because the cycle is complete. So you can continue to heal. The big picture thinking, Pleiades energy, visionary inspired ideas. That's the Hangman energy. You guys know about that higher perspective. So I'm just going to read what the card has to say about it. like Soon As I Get Home by Faith Evans is on. Yeah, I said it right.
Yeah, home. I'll make it up to
you. So some of you guys may be reviewing your past memories, past life memories, past life soulmate memories. Could be why you're isolating. But if it's not practical for you, then it might not be something you need to waste your time out on. Freeze it out. Put it at the back, in the back burner, and focus on things you can like practically take action on now. It's never too late to learn new things, change the future. You're being called to be a visionary for the planet. Take a breath, shake off what you've been taught about the world, hold a new vision for humanity. Big picture thinker. So you're here to generate new ideas for the future, birth a new age and a dream a new world into being. By those with enough courage to question the way things have been and envision new possibilities for the planet. So the world needs more artists, dreamers, inventors, and visionary thinkers. Perhaps you've had an idea recently that you're being called to usher in. The Pleiades supports us in an important stage in Earth development. They want us to know that the decisions we make today will affect the well-being of our planet and all its species. They're calling on you to be a leader of the future. Hold a clear vision of what's possible. Trust that the vision and follow it through with daily action. To dream a new world into being, hold your mind open and try not to worry about what others think. For it takes great courage to pave a new path, to trust a vision before its reality. So your ancestors want you to trust. You are manifesting something here, alchemizing something in your 3D. So keep an open mind. Have a higher perspective about everything. I always take a pause. And I mainly focus on, well, I'm an earth sign as a sun sign, so I'm very practical. It may take me a little bit more time than some of the other signs to like put something into action, but it's because I like to know about all the parts about it, do my research on it, and then once I envision it first, because that's that Pisces energy, then I have a higher perspective. How could this help humanity? Am I doing it out of a heart space, or is it out of materialistic space? And then the next step is like, okay, if it's out of a heart space and it's going to benefit humanity, what's the requirements for it? And then once I figure that out, then you start taking action, like little things day by day. Don't overwhelm yourself. I set healthy boundaries for people, those around me, family, friends. I'll tell them what I'm doing. And like when I can engage and when I can't, when they're taking too much time and space and energy, and then I just kind of pull my energy back. And then overall, we have fall into my arms, surrender, holding the opposites, extremes of life. So you're being asked to surrender, more hangman energy. So the divine wants you to surrender to the divine. Great mother ushered you in when you took your first breath, and she'll be there when you draw your last. She knows how challenging life can be, that being human can be lonely and confusing. The polarity and separation can be excruciating when your soul remembers the oneness of source. It can be also glorious and sweet. So we always see things as good or bad. However, we're all here to expand and grow. It's through the extremes of life that we do that. You're being invited to welcome the highs and the lows of the human experience. To let them initiate you more fully into life. The agony and the ecstasy, the beauty and the bitterness. I've been doing my own thing. Love has always had a way of having bad timing. That would be Tell Me by Groove Theory. Great surprise. Never since I... So some of you guys are going to be taken off guard by this new romantic cycle. But the Mother Earth wants you to fall into her arms, surrender. Hand over your loneliness, worries, hurt, sorrow, fears, burdens, and doubts. So emotionally cleanse. The more wildly the pendulum of your life swings, the more truthfully you can say, I've truly lived. And I can definitely say I've truly lived. I love traveling. Right now I'm practically planning on stability. But once I'm stable, I'm going back to like my dreamy traveling energy, because it's just, that's me. So some of you guys may need to be practical right now. I know I have been. It kind of sucks that I haven't traveled because I usually travel like 6 times a year, to be honest. But I have an overarching goal. So once that goal is complete, and I'm manifesting it in the 3D to be complete, and I'm almost there. I just got one little step that's hindering me. So it'll manifest. So if this one little thing, because it looks like in your mental space, there's one thing here that's got you polarized. It's time to take action. So that's all I could say. Chariot, okay. I was trying to figure out which deck I wanted for your overall reading. Actually, let me do you a love spread. Give me a new beginning. Oh, my love, please tell me what you want. I want you to. I want you to. Okay. Mm-hmm. So would you tell me, tell me, tell me. Oh, so this is the creative love oracle. Sorry, I just kind of like just zone out a little bit sometimes. I got Aquarius in my chart, so that can get kind of very dreamy, dreamy. Aquarius and Pisces, kind of pretty dreamy, so. Okay, so we have chained and bound. Addictions and codependency are affecting your current situation, relationship. You may feel trapped in a connection, situation, and environment. Someone may act possessive and controlling. So if you're feeling that, you're not alone. Other people are going through cleansing out codependent situations. So if your soul is feeling chained and bound, you're not. You just need to practically plan and not focus on that type of energy. And then in your mental space, yeah, boundaries. You need to set better boundaries. Keep your energy balanced and protected. If needed, spend some time alone. It's okay to say no. So I just explained that. I mean, I feel like everything is coming out. Home and family. There might be some changes coming up regarding your current home situation. A relocation could also be possible. This could also stand for starting a family together. So some of you guys may be a little concerned about that, and that's why your soul is feeling locked in. You just need to set more boundaries with people so that you can keep focused on what serves your highest good. And then overall, you and this person are no longer on the same page. What you want in life may differ from what they want. It's time to face if the road ahead is still with this person or if it's better to move on to something new. So a lot of people are, during spring season, going through that. Do you want to go back to, you know, what you know, or do you want a new romantic cycle, something new? So a lot of people are observing right now what it is that they want, and I feel like a lot of you guys are doing that too. The universe is telling you to keep moving forward. This is card number 34. Just observe and keep moving forward and surrender to the universe. And if you're on a different path than somebody else, so be it. Keep going on, keep going forward. Under that is not for you and storm. And then there's true love. So, and then divine counterpart. So, yeah, there is different paths. Some of my Pisces. So this is, oh, I haven't been showing the cards. This is overall. Wow, and then the songs are like just coming right in on time. It's All About Me by Maya. So some of you guys are in this It's All About Me phase. So you're having conflict in your relationship and it's not for you. So you just know, like, this is not for me. It's not serving my highest good. It's a different path than what I want, right? And then that's that 3-3 energy. Like, what type of empress do you want to be? And then some of you guys on the divine counterpart true love path. So if you've done your healing work, because right after that is healing. And then right after that is accept love. Okay, so some of you guys, and then right after that is one more try. And then right after that is take it slow. Right after that says, thank you. That's the end of the card. So I feel like all of those are relevant. Take it slow as practicality. If you're feeling chained in a situation, you're not. Somebody's trying to get you to try have one more try, you don't have to. You're in a healing phase. You're looking to start a new family, but it's best to set boundaries because you need to accept love. You need to love yourself first before you can accept love or have true love because a new romantic cycle began. And you need to decide if you're on a different path than somebody or not because there's a storm going on here and there's new love coming in. So you need to surrender to the divine. If it's not for you, it's not for you. Let it go. Okay. Just going where it goes. So a lot of you guys do need to get selfish. It's about you. Pisces have that very difficult to just focus on you. You're like family oriented, home and family. Family can be stagnating. Yeah, family can be very stagnating. There's nothing, like, I love family, I have family. Everybody has family. You're born into something. But sometimes it's too much. And you gotta just tell people no. You can't spread your cup of love too thin. Like, sometimes you just gotta take a step back. I don't know why. I pulled out the goddess deck, right? But I'm looking at the light seer's tarot. But because I pulled this one out, I might get some clarity from the light seers. Because I'm resonating with both of these decks. So I typically do a pyramid spread for birthdays. So I will be doing that. Not pyramid spread, I consider like a chakra spread as well. So I try to see what's going on in your 3D and I take it all the way up to the crown. My Pisces. Sweet Lady Came On by Tyrese. Okay. Yeah, it's a lot of back and forth going on here. So some of the Pisces, you know where you at. You know what vibe you in. Okay. All my time, I'll be when you need me. Just call it. What I would you, Aquarius and Aries? Okay, so for my Pisces, what I'm looking at in your 3D space, so I pull 7 cards. Okay. Some of you guys are celebrating with friends, having reunions with friends, going back out with friends. 3 of Cups is Cancer energy. So, it could also be like third party situations or so. I'm seeing here that Temperance is balance card, the Sagittarius energy. So some of you guys could be celebrating with a Sagittarius. Have that in your chart. So balancing out friendship situations, stop balancing out friendship groups. So that could be this one more try type of energy. But you guys are 9 of Wands, kind of guarded. 9 of Wands is also Sagittarius energy. So maybe you fell out with a Sagittarius friend or a Sagittarius or a Cancer. And you're trying to balance the situation out, but you're guarded. And in the middle of the spread has to do with your Wheel of Fortune. The wheel is like good or bad karma. What you do always comes back. So if you're doing this with malicious intent and not out of heart, and if it's not for your, like if it's for your highest good, then you'll be on a high wheel. If it's not for your highest good, then you'll get bad karma. So it's like, if you're guarding yourself, and I'm seeing boundaries here, some of you guys are mentally needing to guard yourself in order to balance yourself out and ground yourself when it comes to your friendships. Like, what friends are for you and what's not? Some of them may be trying to, like, chain and bound you into this friendship, and you don't have to be friends with people that you don't want to. And then we have the Seven of Pentacles, practicality, investments, reaping what you sow, results. So if you sow good seeds, you reap a good harvest. That's Taurus energy. So you could be dealing with one of those. Have that in your chart. We have, I mentioned Aquarius. So we have Aquarius. Healing, hope, faith, trust, surrendering to the divine. So that's Aquarius energy. You could be dealing with one of those. I have that in your chart. I just mentioned I have it in mine. But this is not for me because I don't have Sagittarius in my chart. And then we have the Five of Pentacles. Feeling abandoned, left out in the cold, poverty mindset, lack mentality mindset, isolation, Taurus energy. Once again, so we got two Taurus cards, two Sagittarius cards, the Wheel of Fortune. It has multiple signs in it. The fixed signs, though, Scorpio, Leo, which is your opposite sign. So your fortune is telling you to go, like, into your North Node, your Leo energy, action-oriented in your mental space. Guarding yourself in the way that probably a Sagittarius would know how to do. Defending yourself. So I said Leo. Taurus is in that sign, Scorpio and Aquarius. So we got some fixed signs here. So there's some, like, fixed groundedness going on in your 3D, in your root chakra. So you're trying to ground and balance out some friendships that may be not... might not be for you, so you might need to cut some of them off. And some of you guys are feeling cut off already. Some of you guys have got cut off. But if you reap good, if you sow good seeds, you're going to reap good harvest as long as you're in this star energy. So the top major arcana here is the star and the temperance, the balance card. So that's how you ground your Wheel of Fortune into your 3D reality right now. And you just keep reviewing your investments, keep being practical in your plans and your dreams and your goals. Don't worry about this energy because it's off to the side, or this energy is off to the side. So maybe friendships and everything, like, only ones for your highest good, and celebrations for your highest good, things that make you feel isolated and abandoned, and don't pay attention to it. Yeah, things that put you on guard, don't pay attention to it. Okay. You don't feel like I do. Tell me, what can I do? Twisted by Keith Sweat.
Gotta be strong. Did me wrong. And I thought we were really down.
So some of you guys got hurt by somebody.
Moon, make up your mind.
So yeah, some of you guys are trying to hang on to something that doesn't serve your highest good. You just need to focus on what it is that you want out of life right now. Let's get the next sacral. Let's see how your sacral is doing. How the moon come out? So he ain't talking to you. Okay. So you guys have mental clarity. The divine's been sending you messages to give you, help you get mental clarity about what you need to be doing. So this is your special hidden path. This is the moon energy. I'm not going to talk about it because I know.